Welcome back to Conversations. I'm Robin Farr, and as promised, Mark Rogers is here with me today. Mark is a fitness consultant with a special emphasis on working out at home for women. Let me show you his book, Trim, Tighten, and Tone at Home. And the reason I'm having Mark on is because this is going to be all about me today. Welcome to Conversations. It's great to have you here.
Thanks, Robin.
I was really attracted to the email that you sent. Talking about, you know, how people probably would prefer to work out at home if they could. They're not going to the gyms, and yet when they try and work out at home, they have no idea what they're doing. Thus, you've written a book with wonderful illustrations to not just tell, but show exactly how to do it. Is that, am I getting this all right?
Yes, Robin. The reason I wrote the book is because, well, for several reasons, but one is because most of the information out there, especially in books, people are confused. There's not enough photos. There's a lot of text. People are tired and exhausted. They don't want to go through a book that they have to plow through for hours to figure out what they're going to do for their workout. Whereas this book, it's fully illustrated. There's hundreds of photographs, all the exercises. It's very clear. Even the workouts are photographically illustrated for people to be able to pick this book up and use it immediately.
Well, you know, I'm a member of a very lovely gym. I really don't like it that much. It has nothing to do with the gym. It's the idea that it's that I have to leave my house to begin with, right? They seem to have all of the fancy equipment that I need, most of which I don't even use. Are you saying I could get probably a better workout at home with, you know, limited equipment, not all of the fancy stuff, and get in shape, which, by the way, is no longer an option when you get to a certain age, especially for women? Mm-hmm. You have to work out. It's a life or death sort of a thing.
Absolutely. And the way I did it in this book, and this is pretty much the way I train, I sort of modeled it off of that. The only thing you really need for the exercises are an exercise ball, some hand weights, dumbbells, and a weight bench. And you really don't even have to have all those things. You can modify things so that workout will be intense. And it's going to be just as hard, if not harder. I hear clients comment all the time how they're extremely worn out, and they're like, I can't believe you could do this hard of a workout at home.
Right.
And I have people ask me that. They're like, well, how do you do a workout if people don't have equipment? It's like, well, just let me show you.
Yeah, let me show you. Well, in fact, let's take a look. One of the unique things about your book is it's so fully illustrated and shows the rest of us, mm-hmm. this is what it's supposed to look like. It's not just words, it's form. Let's take a look at her. So tell us about what's going on here.
This is a basic squat exercise, and she's holding a dumbbell. Those dumbbells are the type I use with people. They're easy to adjust, and they're compact for small spaces. But she's doing a squat exercise, which is great for the legs and the hips and thighs and whatnot. It's an overall total body exercise, and people get great results, and they complain a lot about it. So,
that's always
working. A good
sign.
No pain.
Right? So she basically's got a yoga mat and then the dumbbells, and that's all she needs. Okay, now we've got her sitting on a bench. Let's talk about this one.
So this one is a shoulder press exercise. So she's sitting there. You could also sit on a ball and do that, or just a regular chair. Like I was saying, you don't have to have the bench, and you're pressing the weights over your head. It's a pretty basic exercise, but it works the shoulders quite well, and people get extremely fatigued, and they'll feel the burn definitely.
All right. Oh, this one looks good. See, I would need the picture, though, to really understand. There's no way you could write in words to tell me to get into that position.
No, definitely not. This side stretch is one of the best stretches. I find clients all the time really enjoy this one because it stretches out your whole body, not only your core, but your arms and everything, and it kind of takes the pressure off people's backs when they get tension, people have back problems, and this one is excellent.
How about this?
This one here is the starting position for an ab crunch, the typical type that people do on the floor, but doing it on the ball gives you a little bit more range of motion, so you fully work the abdominal muscles with this one.
So now next to, and there's just hundreds of these pictures in the book, next to each picture is the description of, yes, now you know what it looks like, here's how many to do, and it just gives you the whole information. You can really do this at home.
Yeah, so it's basically, the book is organized in a manner that's grouped by the area the exercise works. So you have abs, you have legs, and you have arms. And then the second half of the book talks about the actual workouts. So it's workouts for all levels, so beginner, intermediate, advanced, and it's 12-week workouts that vary throughout the whole time period, so you never get bored. That was another thing I wanted to make sure with this book, is plenty of variety of exercises, and it gives the person the option to choose the exercise versus just, okay, you have to do these five and you're going to do this three times a week for the next, you know, 3 months. Mm-hmm. This gives people that option. And there's also sample routines in case the person doesn't want to spend the time to actually pick the exercises they're already set up.
So if someone were to buy your book, mm-hmm. then to get some of the, you know, the very limited equipment is all that is required, mm-hmm. what kind of a time investment would you recommend? And let's talk about women, because I think that mm-hmm. so much of this is directed toward women. What kind of a time investment are you talking, and is it how many times a week?
Well, with the program in the book, you have three times a week of doing the strength training, and then you have twice a week doing cardio, which is in the interval format where you increase the intensity and then drop it back down. It's not the old style where, you know, do an hour of cardio. So all of these workouts, you're done in well less than an hour. And as you get better at them, you can do them quicker. So
okay, so it doesn't really matter that you've spent 45 minutes or 50. It's about what did you get done in that time.
Right, it's the intensity. I mean, I can speak from my own experience. If you do a 20-minute workout that's really, really tough and you're not resting and whatnot, you will get a workout that, you know, you may not get in an hour and a half in a gym where, you know, people are socializing, people are distracting you, and you're having to wait for equipment, that type of thing.
You've worked in a lot of gyms, high-end gyms here in the Tri-Valley and all over the place. You actually have an engineering degree. You know so much about all this. What is it with